Hi, I'm Amy of Amy Nicole Floral, and on today's episode, I'm going to be talking all about floral tape. This is one of my favorite old school floral tricks that really helps to minimize the weight of a bouquet if you're putting together a boutonniere, corsage. It's just one of those things I've been using for years, and I want to show you how to use it. So basically what floral tape is a thin strip of paper that is coated in a paraffin wax. And when it is stretched and pressure is applied, it becomes tacky and it basically sticks to itself. So it's great for not leaving a lot of sticky residue. It can take a little time getting used to using it, but I think it's one of those things that when you, after a while and you really get comfortable with it, it can really be a lifesaver in a lot of different projects that you're doing. So, it also comes though in several colors, and I want to highlight those really quickly. It comes in this great white color, and this is awesome if you're using flowers like stephanotis or gardenias or even white orchids, dendrobiums, phalaenopsis, and you want to wire through the top of the flower. You can tape right in the center of the wire, bend it into a U shape, and then you don't see any of that green wire. So it's just those small kind of finishing moments, especially if you're having a bouquet that's shot really closely. You don't want to see any kind of green wire sticking out. So white's a great option to have. Typically brown, green, dark green, light green, black. Those are the most common ones that I use because they mimic most closely the color of a stem. However, over the years, they've also started coming out with some really bright, fun colors. This is a metallic gold. I've used this stylistically in making little mini petite bouquets. It comes in red and yellow and blue, so there's some really fun choices as well. But floral tape is very inexpensive, and again, once you know how to use it, really you can do so many different things with it. So today I'm just going to simply show you how to tape a wire. Obviously you would be probably incorporating flowers into this for a hair crown, or maybe you would be wiring some flowers for a cascade bouquet. I've made all kinds of different things where I've needed to minimize that stem, minimize the weight of the stem, and it allows for more flexibility in whatever it is that you're making. So this is a really useful tool. So I'm going to teach you how to do it. What I like to do is pull a good yard or so, so that I'm not obstructed as I'm taping down the wire. I take my tip of my tape and I go underneath the wire, and I use my left hand. I'm right-handed, so you're going to do this opposite if you're left-handed. So I'm going to take the tip of my tape and I'm going to pinch it over the top, and I'm going to keep my tape at about a 45 degree angle, and I'm going to stretch the tape out very firmly, and with my left fingers I'm going to pinch really hard and roll it. Okay, this hand is really just the guiding of the tape. It's its only job. This left hand is doing all the work. So as I roll down, I'm continuing to support the tape around the wire, and I'm pinching and twisting really hard. And I want to show you why this is important. So I'm going to get all the way to the end here. Just rips off pretty easy. So what we have is a really clean taped wire. This is great if you're going to make a hair crown, like I mentioned, if you need to cover up some kind of mechanic. But here's what I see often done. Somebody may take floral tape, and what they do is they just kind of wrap it around like this. And it's just kind of wrapped. I see this a lot. So it seems like it would stick, right? It kind of feels like, well, yeah, I don't see what the problem is. But let me show you. So I'm wrapping, I'm wrapping, I'm wrapping. Do you see how much tape I'm using? I'm using so much extra tape. So not only am I wasting product, I'm wasting time and labor. And what starts to happen is it gets really bulky and it doesn't stick. So what can happen is this. All of a sudden, you're working and the tape is just bunching and falling off. I wonder if that's ever happened to you. I know it's happened to me before I learned how to do this. So here's a tip. If you have never done this before, get yourself some tape and use a hyacinth stick. This is a wooden dowel that's used usually up the stem of an amaryllis stem or a hyacinth to support the stem. So it's really helpful to practice on a larger gauge wire or a stick. You can also use a rose stem if you don't have any of these. And the larger the stem or the stick, it's much easier to practice this motion of stretching and pulling. It's really rhythmic. And you know you've done it properly when you can pull both sides and tape isn't moving around. That's what you want. So you can also use a 16 gauge wire, an 18 gauge wire. Just start working your way up to thinner and thinner wires. And I know you'll get more comfortable with it. I hope you try floral tape if you haven't before. And thanks again for watching, and hope to see you next time.